Welcome, my friends, to Death Roads Tournament. Finally, a game where the Punisher headband is maybe even more appropriate than Marvel Snap. This is a Mad Max-themed roguelike deck builder. If you want to go even farther down the B-movie inspiration, a Death Race-inspired roguelike deck builder. It is very hard, very crunchy, but still fairly accessible to be able to get in and understand what's going on. Here we get to pick our driver. He's got three cards associated with him. These are cards that will be available to us every single turn. Of having him as the driver, and he also has this starting gadget giving you 10 block at the start of your first turn of battle, helping you stay alive just a little bit longer. So we are going to continue here, and then we get to choose our car. We're just going to grab this basic car here. We've got forward-facing Gatling guns, diagonal forward-facing shotguns, and a rear-facing mega gun. I love it. And so then all of the car components is what feeds into the rest of the cards that make up your deck that you're going to be cycling around. And we don't have any additional layouts right now. We'll take Buck Continental. Lock and load. So, welcome to the United Wastelands. We can choose our starting position, which also is choosing what sponsor is going to be fueling us for the rest of the race, and then we get to pick our path all the way till all roads intersect at what I assume is supposed to be New York, though it seems to be a little bit off-setted from where New York would normally be. What do we want to be able to grab as sponsor? Honestly, put me on roads where I'm going to remember where I'm driving. Something through cutting through Kansas. That sounds fun. So you are post-app. You gain 20% more scrap from each battle. Scrap directly translates into money. At the cities, your rewards are either scrap or components at the end of every battle. And then at the cities, it's a novel concept. You can exchange one for the other. The last thing to die in the post-apocalyptic wasteland is capitalism. These are healing stations, and then these are shops. I don't want a healing station immediately. I sure hope not. Let's actually go for post-app, just be able to make additional money. Because at the chop shop, or that the healing stations, that can translate into healing, or it can translate into extra gadgets. It's just so flexible. It keeps us open. We're going to go there. Let's go. All right. The rest of the competitors all drop in. These are bosses, and they will randomly follow routes. If you hit a city that intersects with them, then you get the boss battle to have to knock them out. They will knock each other out if they hit intersections. But if you hit an intersection with multiple ones of them, they pretty much all gang up on you. So you got to be very careful on that. You also got to be careful if you're going to make it to the end, and then they're all converging as well. You could be in for an insanely hard final challenge. So I'm actually interested in maybe meeting this guy early on while we are potentially very healthy. Let's slide along here. He doesn't want it. He's going to go farther south. That's fine by me. I will first battle up against a little chase drone. See how this goes, and we'll break into the basics. Okay, so car. Red is the health, blue is your handling or your grip. The cards have a cost in the top left that will decrease your grip. If you hit zero, then you go into a skid. You draw from your skid deck and you just move around uncontrollably, bashing into things, and if you bash into off the road, you take extreme damage. Very bad, very dangerous, especially at higher speeds, because what gear you are in, you see the one here and then the one down here, that's what gear we are in. The higher gear we are when we enter a skid, then the more cards we have to draw. Why would you want to be in a higher gear then? Because all the cards have a breakdown like this, where at the higher gears, you effectively always get better stuff. Faster is better. It's just more dangerous if you're going to go into a skid. So, how do we want to deal with this little chaser? These forward diagonal guns not helping us in this scenario. We'll drop these down. Okay. Did not draw any guns. We can still deal damage to the opponent by trying to bash into them. Let's see, how can we make this happen? I need to get into a higher gear. We're gonna go to tune in, gear up, take a little bit of grip back, to the right, then we can Breaking Bad straight into our little drone friend. That's one, that's two. Each indicator here is one space backwards or forwards or side to side. Get a second bash. Armor up, and then I think we try and get out of the way. Yeah, we'll move over here. This transitions from asphalt into gravel, and as soon as you transition, you actually go backwards. That put us into a skid. Thought we had another grip left. Okay, never punished, never punished. But there you go, that's the skid mechanic. You will never be able to move forward in a skid. You just move side to side and backwards, and you usually go down in a couple gears. All right, he had to reposition, hits us with the laser. Our shield blocks it all. Now our shield is gone. Great burst. Right on. Done and dusted with. Ooh. Sweet victory. Now we reap the rewards. We gain 4 scrap for fighting him. And then I gain the extra 20%, so up to 5 scrap. So impressive. Thank you, my sponsors. I'd like to thank my sponsors. Now we get to pick our component to improve our vehicle with. This one would give us additional max health, which seems really nice. The cards don't seem particularly appealing, but we could make them work. You would be able to replace the shotguns with a AoE right around our vehicle. That could be nice. Also you, just a number of different cards. Honestly, I'm going to go with the component that improves the chassis. We'll equip that. That seems to be the most desirable. And we'll just learn how to deal with our cards. Still pretty early to try and like hone in on a build. Ooh, finally. Normally in the beginning, they just throw you up against a bunch of drones. But here we have our first actual vehicle combatant. Much more durable than the drones. Always want to check and see what their loadout is. So they're using the AoE. Shot, I gotta stay away from him, if at all possible. This lane is going to become gravel. That means if you end your turn in that lane, you'll get slowed down. Detrimental to us here. Anticipation. Gear up. And then get to trade. Not gonna use the forward shot. Probably not going to use to the... No, I do want to use to the right. I want to get into this lane. Turbo lag. Sure, I'll drop you off. And then I get the grip. Perfect. Double barrels, you're not gonna help me. Hands off, keep on cycling the deck. Double barrels, get out of here. To the left, get out of here. Here we go. So now I could either try and accelerate away from him, or we could try and bash him around a little bit. I think I'm gonna accelerate away. Move up into third gear, advance ahead. To the right. Get to the side just a little bit. Weight transfer. Forward and shield. Okay, let's see him catch up and see how we can whittle him down. Need time to be able to cycle for our rear-facing weapons. Or a good time to put him into a skid. Weak throttle got him all the way up here. And then he gets a bash too. Okay, we're hanging strong. Didn't actually take damage, I don't think, because of our shielding. Direct shot. Then... let me drop on him. That puts him into a skid. Yes, he's at the edge. Come on. It's between 10 and 15 damage when you hit the guardrails, so it's terrible if you're on the edge there and then you go into a skid. So the vehicle giving us a little bit more scrap, up to 14. Still nothing to really write home about. All right. What do we like? Laser tail. So this would do piercing damage, but less of it. Or I could go for the plow. The plow seems kind of fun. You get to do a really heavy attack directly in front. And then you... hang on, what is this? Fragile move forward. You would push them ahead. Okay. Maybe I do just take the laser. Yeah, but I'm actually just going to collect it. We can sell that at a city for a couple extra scrap. Right here, actually. So, I think actually I go through the scrapyards just to get the bonus right now. We'll try and do a shop run later. We get a new engine. We'll look at that in a sec. And then the scrap. Move me on out. Perfect. Okay. Repair yard over here. You're still taking the farthest southern route. Captain is coming along up here. You guys are moving along. Maybe I want to get into the action. Nope, I will. With this route, I will never be able to. Though I can guarantee an intersection for the mini boss fight down here and move on up to the finals. Okay, that seems like our route. Lose 10 health, gain a component. Average looking guy stops you with a wave. He says, hey, I got an unusual thing to ask of you. Can I shoot your car? No, don't shoot my car. Road battle, dive in. Two enemies in pursuit. To the right, to the right. Hang on. Can I gear up first? I think that we should tune in to gear up first. There we go. Then, to the right moves me all the way down. I would really rather focus fire the drone out, because his gun still hurts, but he has the lowest health. Try and knock him out as soon as we can. These forward weapons, they're not doing anything. There we go, straight back, perfect. Choo. Bounce around a little, jump to the left. What are you rocking? A forward harpoon. Okay, so actually, maybe being like to the side is safer? Maybe. I'm just gonna end. We have 10 shield. He has to reposition a little bit to be able to use the weapon. Kill lane opens up. Gravel opening up. There goes the harpoon. That wheels, that pulls me back. And then he gets a bash? That doesn't seem fair. Okay, still all forward facing weapons. We need to retool something here. When we are being chased, this is terrible. Weight transfer right into him. We could set up a skid here. If I ride on. Bash. Drops him down. He falls back. Moves up. Okay. Power shift. Get me moving. Then. Agile shift. That'll take me up. Max gear. Let's cycle some things. Bouncing around. Turbo lag. I don't know. These are fine cards if we're like close to him. Maybe I drop bouncing around. He is to the left of me. We need new wheels too. We need so much new stuff. All right, just end here. Engines in the red, engines in the red. And then a rock is gonna come down. Take 5 damage to the lead car in that lane. Gets the bash off. You guys a double bash? Okay, but no harpoon attack. I'll shoot you. And then, this weight transfer is looking nasty. The turbo lag is also great, but this would shield us. Let's do that. Shield up. Goes into a skid. Drops back. He's also in the lane that'll take damage from the rock. It's the side he's done for. It's over. Oh, he comes back. He comes back. He regained control. Alright, power shift me back. I didn't want to have to do this to you, but tag, you're it. Scrap into the collection, and then new wheels, finally. Oh boy. Hot wheels. Burn. At the beginning of your turn, discard 2 random cards from your hand, then lose 1 burn. That's abysmal. But it would also affect the opponents if we bashed into them. Okay. Beginner's turn with the cones. And then, so you make a turn and then you wheel lock so that you can't turn again. I can't replace my rear-facing gun. I need that guy. But the mortar sounds psycho. 10 damage and it makes them brittle. I think we're just taking this aluminum racing wheels. I mean, it gives us so much more flexibility, and then touch the sky. You hit them with the rubble, so they get damage over time if you bash into them with Touch the Sky. We're gonna go here. That music transition is always so abrupt. Okay, so here. Repair station. Repair station or pick up more scrap. I am gonna try and stay topped off because every fixed station has a little bit of health for free. So we're gonna just thrive on those freebie coupons. Punching our ticket there. Yep, there we go. Okay, head me out. Now, let's slide into our showdown. Well, we could postpone and then make sure that we meet up later, or we could take a now. Are we ready? We get 2 battles. We're max health. Here's the thing. And on one of these future ones, we could be going in with more damage. We have a chance to heal right after. I think this is it. This is the opportunity. The opportunity of the race. Itch ahead. Okay. So you have the AoE. Yep. And you have the same. Great. Well, I don't want to be caught next to you guys, but I want you guys to get caught next to each other. All right, I'm just jamming out of the music here. Double barrels is lined up right now, but I could also set up the double straight burst into this guy. Let's take the forward shots while we can. Another three grip. It's a lot of damage. Can I come up alongside and play bumper cars? Right on. The turbo lag only happens if you're up in third gear. Oh, but the agile shift would get me into third gear. The possibilities. Honestly, I don't know. Yeah, I could bump him, but then he's just going to be able to, like, really lay into me with this attack. 10 damage each time. I'm going to take so much damage here. We'll go down fighting in first gear. Here we go. Weight transfer. There's a shot. Then the second shot. All right, we're hanging tight, hanging strong. He moves up, misses with the bash. AOE. Honestly, it could have been worse, I guess. Seems fine. Okay, I get to shift. And then I could bash you, throw you into a skid. See you bash me back? No, go to the wall. It's terrible. Tune in. To get this guy. I need the shield, I think. Help mitigate some damage. But also, I should throw him into a skid. I was like, I need to go with the straight back, but if we push him into the skid, then hopefully he falls out of position to be able to double tap us with his gun. There we go, he's falling back. That's good. That's what we want to see. Comes back around. He's not that far from us. Okay, this could be a worse position than before. But I don't know if we had the capability to finish off his buddy here. We go into a skid. Moving up. Oh, this is going to hurt us. Move, move, move. No. Oh. Well, we got the bash back, which throws him into a skid. The cascade, and then he just pulls back. He recovers. He's going to advance. Actually, I think we're okay. I don't think this is triggering this turn. I think it's triggering at the end of my turn. Actually, that was great. That worked out fantastic. Great burst. Get rid of you. Then I could actually go for a... I have the lead spray. Let's tune in first to see where the skid takes him. Down and out. Now, if I was in a much higher gear, I could angle shift right into him, but maybe I still should. Yeah, let's do that. Take me up into third gear. Drop the forward-facing guns. And then... bouncing around is not bad. I do have to leave this lane. Honestly, I probably should cut up, right? Alright, we'll bounce around up here. And then say, catch me if you can. Which, I know he can, but... touch the sky. Alright. He's moving in pursuit. Now his weapon will catch us. That damage, it's so much. Okay. If I really want to drop back a little bit and then use touch the sky on him, but I could also just move to the side. I think moving to the side is by far and away the better decision here. Great back, and then catch him with, you know, the power shifts don't do it, but the turbo lag does. And then in fifth gear, the power shifts do allow me to drop back. It's getting around. He comes back for more. Just a glutton for punishment. There we go, that's one. That's two. Right on. Into the sunset. Handled that one quite well. What is this? Ooh. The Spitfire Custom Steam Engine? It's a steam engine on my car? What do? You move backwards after... people caught in it would get pushed backwards. Okay, okay. Launch control sounds great. Sounds very fun. But what about these wheels? Less bashing, more health. And then on the engine, more bashing, less health. I'm gonna go for the custom steam engine. Way easier to be able to catch people behind us with the spread. Ah, yes, closing in. Closing in on our boss battle. Just have to deal with these two bozos. So you are side-to-side damage handling, and then behind, I need to get ahead of you. These plasma trails are terrible. Look at this, 8 damage and 8 grip. We'll throw into skids all over the place. Yeah. Accelerate me, power shift is just right. Hang on. Do I have you in sight right now? I do. Well, this doesn't happen very often, so I'll take it. Look at that. The efficiency on those, you've never seen it higher. Get me out of here. I need to do a passing maneuver here. The turbo lag, turbo doesn't do it. I need cycle you guys. Though you take me into a higher gear, maybe turbo lag's actually what goes. Nope, not good. Right on. Right on and hold tight. Though I could do a steady turn, no. That would put me into a skid immediately. Okay. I probably am getting put into a skid here. If he uses his side burst, damage my handling, and we're right up against the guardrail. Okay. Or the canyon edge, however you want to say it. Yeah, the drone doesn't get an attack. He moves ahead, and then across. Yep, here it comes. Puts us into a skid. Not good, not good. That is good. Middle of the road, just stay here. Perfect. That's actually great for us. So good. SMG burst, light him up. 3 and 12. I could. Let's gear up. Throttle up, throttle up. Drop. Bouncing around. Drop. You? Alright, what do we get? Forward guns. Forward. Power shift is good. Up into 4. That puts him into a skid. Out of second gear, pulls to the side, drops back, nope, comes back in front. He wants more. Alright, we get him here, and then we're able to armor up ourselves, and, I mean, I can ride on. I'd also probably get put into a skid myself. Yeah. I think we just hold tight. The road closes in even tighter. Drone makes his attack. Yeah, okay, that's all on the shield though. Pretty good here. He gets shifty, bashes us, pulls to the side, warms up the laser, sends us into a skid. That's why I'm happy that we were in the center of the road. Okay, come on, don't clip the wall. The bash, no, get me back into the middle, skid into the middle. Recover control. Come on, Zed, I know you could. Yes! I knew it was in him. Heart of the cards, heart of the cards. Get him out of here. One down. Launch control. Oh, and it damages his handling. He's in fifth gear. Come on, throw him into the chasm. Yes! What a move. We just vaporize him with our exhaust. Beautiful stuff. Oh. We could get the exact laser weapon that I was so afraid of. Or we could get dramatically improved handling, right? Handling regen, yeah. Easy, babe. What? Shift up, move around, extra handling. That seems good. Heavy footwork. That seems quite good as well. I'm tempted. Though I do love touch the sky. I'm pretty happy with what we've got, I think. I don't know. Am I? Yeah, the Slight Shift is a good card as well. But do I want to change this for the Laser Burst? Very similar. The Plasma Trail does additional handling damage and additional body damage, but it covers a smaller area and it can only affect two enemies, whereas this would be able to affect as many as are there and also pushes them backwards. And this one also is the current thing is also giving us additional bash handling damage. I told you guys, it's a crunchy game. I will collect you, but I will not equip you. As we head in for our showdown. Let's go. Okay, 61 scrap. I think that we need to go through, hang on. Let me check my garage. Do we have stuff to sell? We do. We might be able to pick up an additional gadget in here. If we're careful. Yeah, but we gotta spend it now. Here we go. First, we're gonna sell. Hey, Grandma. How would you like some V6 turbo? Some rusty touring wheels? A Gatling turret? And a Trailblazer. She loves them. She eats them up. Now, double the condition damage of your first bash you perform on each of your turns. Yeah, that sounds great. Your weapon cards deal two extra damage more if you haven't played any weapon card on the last turn. I love the double bash damage. That resets every turn as well. That seems crazy. I'll take it. Swift Daddy Hands. I like him. Alright, what are you looking like? So, you've got the flamethrower and the side blasters. And you light yourself on fire when you skid? Okay. I'm good with this. The dude's gonna take it to the Swift Daddy. We wanna get ahead of him. Then he's not capable of damaging us, really. We'll take this shot while it presents itself, though. Power shift up. Straight into a lead spray. Maybe that just seems really good. Power shift up again. Come on. Right on. If I bounce around, or maybe we go steady turn for the grip. Right, just tune in. I think I'll just tune in here. Yeah, we get the bash because the gravel slows us down right into him. Perfect. We get the launch control and touch the sky. Ooh. Okay, so all the lanes are changing. He does the bash, throws us into a skid. A little bit of bumper cars. We'll bash back there. Perfect skid draw. Still holding. That's good. Still holding. That's good. His weapons don't face forward. He'll just have to bash us the whole time. Now he's moving around. He's trying to make a pass. He throws himself into a skid and gets pulled back. Okay. I mean, I want to do it. But also, is it going to help me? I need to stay on him. I need to touch the sky, being side to side. I feel like it would be beneficial to go... That's the only rear-facing weapon I have. Let's go hands off, bounce around, steady turn, drop you, draw, rate transfer, that's what I want to see. Shift up, drop, light shift, and the double barrels. Here we go. Now... Yes, I can weight transfer right into you. No, it's only a 1. I have to be in gear 4 for it to drop all the way back. Well, okay. In anticipation, I'll jump up, cycle this card for turbo lag. That's actually perfect. It's perfect. Now I go weight transfer, bash, armor up, turbo lag into him. Knocks him back even farther. And then... No. Not touching this guy. Oh, launch controls. Hang on. Why can I not? I got locked for some reason. Weapon lock. He locked my weapons out of one of his matches. Somehow, someway, he did it. Okay. I think I'll just get some more space between us then, and wait for the recycle. This feels like it's going incredibly well for us. Our quick pass, I think, has got us through the boss. Here he comes. If he'd hit us, we would have lit on fire. Flips us there. Oh, he's stacking up debris. Every time he bashes us there, I get debris. That's damage over time. So I'm going to take 7 damage, and then next turn I'm going to take 6, and then I'm going to take 5. It's a quick death. Well, it's a slow death, I guess, but it catches up to you pretty quick. We can dance around. So I would come up, I would bash him, I would move back to the side. I would then slow down. I would touch the sky to clip him and give him a taste of his own medicine. Then I would, I would accelerate. When am I going to use launch control? I want to use launch control, but I also really want to get the touch the sky on him. If he's going to be so rude so as to use all the debris on me. Oh, here we go, here we go. It's all coming together. I then bounce around into the gravel lane, which pulls me back. So now when we touch the sky, we get the bash, stacks the gravel on him. Now I can ride on. Hang on. Yeah, kind of. I can ride on. But it's not going to be able to hit him right where it is, right? Yeah. It's out of range. So then I have to agile shift, steady turn. I guess it's an agile shift. Take me down into second gear because I'm thinking that I'm about to enter a skid. Move me up. Then cycle the lead spray in the steady turn. Nice, nice. Burn him. That pushes him back, puts him into a skid. Into the gravel, puts me into a skid. Up. Good, good, good. More separation is better. And then back. Okay, okay, that's fine, that's fine. Whose car is gonna break down first? Now, here's the terrifying thing is that with all this damage that we've taken, I don't know how we're making it to the next repair station. But I'm not gonna give you... That pushed me as well? We might not make it to the... out of the battle. I was getting all cocky like we had it handled. Okay. We do have great forward-facing ordnance. Give me... tune in. Then, I just need to be right in this position, and we hit him with 19 damage. We got a cycle. Turbo lag, hour shift, anticipation. It's probably this shot that should... well, maybe it's this one that goes... I'd really like to get right behind him so that I can bash him to pieces. Maybe I do need it though. All right, you're gonna go. You're gonna go, confirm. Nope. These are not what I wanted. Oh man. I mean, I could try accelerate. I could decelerate to hit him with the double barrels. What do you do behind you? Not much, actually. Okay. Okay. The plan is coming together. We decelerate. That armor's up. Then I catch him with the double barrels for an extra 9. I can anticipation into third gear. Drop the power shift and the turbo lag. Give myself the grip. I've got launch control. Okay, now we're stuck. We've got 2 grip on the car, but then we've got an extra 3 here. The side lanes are going crazy. Planning his turn. What's he gonna do? There's damage in both of these lanes if you're the lead car. This is not a good spot for him. Oh, but he got the tough tackle. Then he bumps again. And again. Throws us into a skid. Just spit it out, man. And then back up. Oh. 9 damage. We have to end it here. My weapons are locked? Are you kidding me? Okay, okay. Cycle, cycle. Hands off. Get rid of the weapons. Maybe it's enough. Ride on. Bounce around. Give me the bash. It's pretty good. Turbo lag. It's so little. Gotta go for it. I don't know if I need to go all the way up. I think I just give him the bash. No! Not a- Whoa, wait. This might get him. Yes! Steady turn! Steady turn into the fast lane, mate. See ya! Swift Daddy goes down. That's 40 scrap all for me. Juicy, juicy. What can we rip off his car? All his mismatched tires? I don't know. I like my tires. But this was what he was using, I think. Maybe. Maybe the, handling regen is what we want. That could be nice. Be able to have additional handling every turn to play more cards. Or additional bash damage. Let's go right here. Let's give some new wheels a try. We'll equip you. Hand limit is increased by 1 because of the memory card. Ooh. Handy dandy little gadget ripped off his car. Maybe we'll be able, we're at 12 health. We are so dead. Okay, what's the regen modifier do for me? Main deck, sort by, skid deck, okay. Handling regeneration modifier. Yes. Handling is 12. So what I wanted really, I guess, was max handling. Maybe we just go back to these guys. Yeah, it stays at 12. Okay. I'm pretty sure there's a way to be able to get this number higher. What the regen modifier is going to do is it gives me a little bit more out of a skid. Which, if you're skidding around, is already a bad situation. At the beginning of your turn, you get a full refresh. This seems like a very poor modifier. Are the cards nice enough to run? They're good cards. But also, I mean, these are good cards. Okay. 12 health. Save my changes. Take me into a battle. I might not have died to the Swift Daddy, but I don't know if we're making it to New York. Gotta get past this guy. Can I just run away? I could just run away. We have 5 retreats remaining. What do you have? Yeah, so any laser tap is gonna just like vaporize us. How to run away. He's 60 health. He's so tough. Let's try a slight shift into second gear. Change lanes. Ride on. That drops us back. I need everything that moves me backwards. Hands off. I mean, the weapons are okay. Power shift, you're going to move me forwards. That's not what I want. Move backwards. Power shift. Okay, fine. Steady turn. Take me to the other side of the road, I suppose. Rip up. No, I don't have it. Alright, end. We'll take some pot shots if we can, but what I'd like to do is I'd like to drop so far back that we escape. Still hits us. Shield hail. The shield holds. Does throw us into a skid. If you're up. Goodness. Maybe fate has decided that we're gonna live a little longer. Alright, hit him. That's pretty good damage. Hit him again. Now I need to shift up to get the shield from the weight transfer. Okay. Hold on. You don't have really anything side to side, as I remember. Yeah, I'm in a bit of a safety zone if I'm like directly alongside you. And that's where I touch the sky. Loves to live. Alright, I thought I was getting out. They pulled me back in. Armor up. Hold tight. What's the play? I think he's gonna try and use the lasers on us. Yeah. Ooh, he got a shield himself. 10 health. Oh, into a skid? No. Not like this. Okay. Shoot him. A little bit of damage there. Gifts me up. Third gear. Cycles my cards. Launch control, you're not it. Turbo lag, you might be it. Touch the sky, you might be it. Bouncing around in this position, you're not. The double barrels. And I get bouncing around back. I have to be next to him for touch the sky to do anything. Okay, hang on. We ride on. That pulls me up. Turbo lag. Takes us into fourth gear. Bashes him. For the additional damage. Puts him into a skid. He's in the perfect position for the shotgun. Nope. He slides back out. Okay. I tune in. Here's the thing. He's gonna murder me. With the laser now. It played right into it. Double barrels while we're here. Puts me into a skid and maybe positions me away. Alright. That turn was not too well thought out, but maybe the skid actually brings us into a better position. I'd like to go down one more lane. One more lane down, please. Go backwards? Okay, fine. Now he's gonna come back at us. Sliding up. Moving forward. The laser still hits all the way back here. 2-1. We're so dead. Unless what? Unless... What I need is cards that would shield me. Hands off. Launch control, you're not it. Slide shift, you might be. I mean, any of these are interesting, and anticipation would allow me to keep on cycling. Part of me is seeing, like, not seeing touch the sky connect. We'll see. Weight transfer finally gives me a shield just to get killed still. Unless I'm in the maximum gear. Okay, that would take me up to third. That would take me into fifth. Okay, we're okay. We're barely okay, but we do live to fight another game. Another turn. So then, I take you into fifth gear. And I move... right into position. To be able to take the shot. And then weight transfer away. Armor up by 8. Okay. That was the move. We're making moves. Are they good moves? Flies to the side. Comes back. Moves back again, makes the shot, all on the shield, we get thrown into a skid. It is a fifth gear skid. Can I just like drop back farther and farther, please? There you go, yeah, more of that. And again. Okay, moving down, gotcha. Well, how much health does he have? 13? Against all the odds, we made it. Power shift me up. World lead spray. We got him. Right out. Hang on. You gotta be careful. Let's spray. Needs me to be right here. Yes. We can do it. We can do it. Right on. Wait, am I cutting myself? Yeah. Okay. Go in. We squeaked it out. We live to drive another day. Oh no. How much longer? Two health? The check engine light's just flashing constantly now. Oh no. Upgrades, upgrades. You know, the shotguns did okay in that battle. I think they deserve to stick around a little while longer. The wheels? Maybe it's time to bring in new wheels now. Touch the sky? We've not really gotten it to pop. I'm gonna go for you. Equip you. 19-inch touring wheels. A full heal? No! Lose 15 health. I don't have 15 health. Let's not risk it. This is it. The fix station. I have to make it through... a 3-enemy battle. With 2 health. Okay. Let's get out of here. I think we escape. Everybody? Most everybody? I'm just wondering. Okay. We have 5 escapes total. That's per vehicle that we escape. What we could do is we could escape 2 of them and then say, I think I can beat 1 vehicle with only 2 health. Or we can say that's crazy. There's no way you're even beating 1 vehicle with 2 health and you just gotta pedal to the metal, get out of here. You know? I think we're on the pedal to the metal, get out of here train. So, power shift me. Second gear. Move forward. Weight transfer. You're actually very important with the shield that you provide. Maybe you go last in case I get into a higher gear. You will allow me to hit third gear. Move up on the heavy footwork. Ride on. We're distancing. Weight transfer. Alright, one of them's gone. Armored up. And I think that we just hold. I got another power shift. That's more forward movement. That's good. The other guy's trying to keep up. He only moved up 2 spaces. Okay, that's good. That's good. We'll outdistance him easy. This guy is able to come alongside. No. His weapon is only, oh, there we go. And then he gets the bash, which throws us into a... Oh, we held, we held. I thought we were going to go into a skid there. I can throw him into a skid if I want to push backwards, basically. Anticipation. Gear me up. Drop the lead sprays. We're not using those. No chance. And then, yep, additional traction. Okay, turbo lag. I think that's the answer. You turbo lag bash. That moves him back, puts him into the skid. Hopefully, he falls back a little bit farther. Then throttles down a little more. Okay, well, not a great skid, but it did move him back. Power shift. Fifth gear. Move up. Hands off these weapons. Yeah, no one's ahead of us. No, nothing? Actually nothing? Hang on. Launch control. That pushes it back farther. Beautiful. Then, with rattlesnake, nope, that's a bash, just ride on. Just ride on. Somebody got hurt there. They're trying their hardest. But we are a wily one to catch. They don't have any range to be able to reach us. Oh, but he's got the diagonal. Okay. This guy might actually have the best range. He's got the diagonal shooters. He can reach 2 squares up if he's in the right position. He's trying. Yeah. This would... The agile shift allowed me to cycle some cards. But it wouldn't give me any forward motion. Like, all these guys, I don't don't know, but the weapons aren't doing anything either. Cycle them around. Let's spray. Okay, what gave me the redraw? Agile ship. I'll stay in fifth, thank you. No, I have to change. I have to change. I'll go into fourth. I have to move. I will go here. Then. I'm not going to do any rupture or bouncing around. Well. Yeah, I'm probably not going to use bouncing around or lead spray. I have two power shifts. Up into fifth. Move me up. Move me up again. Two. Come on. Right on. Come on. Anticipation. Drop it. Drop it. Heavy footwork does move me ahead one more. Oh, yeah. Traction. Launch control. It's heavy footwork. For three. Back into fifth gear. Move to the side. Yeah, move ahead. All the escapes. All the escapes. Weight transfer is good. Power shift is good. Plus ride on. I think we can make it. I think we can make it. Especially if he comes up close enough. Yeah, we got it. Ha ha. Repair station, here we come. We live to drive another day. I thought we were gone. Did not think we were going to make it out of that one. Man, the 10 health shield at the beginning of the battle, that saved us. Controlled chaos. Wow. Maybe it is time to get a new engine. I would get additional handling and regen. That sounds nice. Actually, yes. Let's equip you. Two health. As we crawl into New Orleans. Fix station. Howdy, boys. Push it to the limit. Give me the half health. Oh, it's so expensive. Can I trade you guys components for additional repairs? I've got some good stuff. Okay, we get a second station here, so we need to make as much scrap as possible to repair. And then we'll come on here. Hopefully the captain decides to face us here. And then we get the final showdown shortly thereafter. The lottery. Riding into a decently sized town, you see some kind of spectacle. Small stage, three huge curtains numbering from 1 to 3, a whole lot of townsfolk around. Turns out your loyal fans have organized a lottery just for you. Do we want what's behind door number 1, door number 2, or door number 3? We have gained. We have to go into the garage to see what this is looking like. Okay, take me to engines. The turbo rotary. I just upgraded this into something else, but, I mean, reload, it intrigues me. A lot of shield, and I love shield. Hard hit. Punches up and back, and also card draw at the max gears, and then the violator. The violator moving around and then kind of bashing around. Versus what we have now. Bashing around a lot. I have reload. Hulk or bulk. I love that. And anticipation. Sorry, fans. I'll sell that, though. You help me on the way, one way or another. Rude battle. Okay, this I think we have to fight for the scrap. But we need to be clever. Okay, the chase drone, the rocket and grenade launcher, and then you have the forward-facing harpoons and the rear-facing hull. 11 damage. Yeah, that guy looks terrible. So I can lead spray straight into you. Then I wanted to move so I would catch the drone. Okay, we still got him. We need to gear up. Gear up, move backwards, and then weight transfer, I think, is the play. Do I could rattlesnake? No. It's footwork. gear up, move back, give him a weight transfer. I don't have the traction. Okay, 10 shield, preserve me. SMG shot, looking good. Nope, he moves to the side. Then he drops back even more. And he lets us have the grenades. Not too bad. This guy moves back, then he's gonna harpoon us. Yep. Pulls us in. And again. Bonus bash. And again. I love it. That throws him into a skid. The cascading effects are wild. Moves back into position to take more punishment. Love to see it. Okay, we need to gear up, to be sure. I think that's you. Put me into third. Take out Rupture and Rattlesnake. Everything else, my engine cards are what's really rocking it here. Controlled Chaos, we get the double bash. That's looking pretty good. Yes, also the Hulk or Bulk, looking great. Just can't use that at a first. Got it. And the weight transfers, we have shield coming in a lot of different positions. Let's go controlled chaos. Give him the double bash. That'll put him into a skid. In second gear, not much happening there. He does slide away quite a bit. Okay. Then, we're gonna Hulk up and do a weight transfer, which would let me drop way back or rush way up. I'll rush way up and get the armor. Hang on. I played the Hulk or Bulk completely wrong, right? I played the aspect that, yeah, did not give me nearly as much shield. Okay, well, you live and you learn. Do you have anything that's side to side? Your grenades are still like behind you. Okay, so actually if I was to ride on here, I'd feel pretty good. What is happening back there? I'm sure he will catch up eventually. Let me give me the bash. The double bash. We have so much shielding and handling that we lasted pretty well there. He's still coming at me. This is crazy! I'm down to 21 health already and I have still 3 debris to get through. And then I skid out. Okay, right behind him. Yeah, that's not where I wanted to be. Eh, maybe it is with the SMG shot. He's trying to make ground on us. And now he has the harpoon that still hits. Pulls back. Is this where it ends? Can I get out of here? I need to be in fifth gear. Pronto to get this 8 shield. Feels like the best move I can get, maybe. You would sabotage the car behind us. The launch control. You would take me up a gear. You would take me up 2 gears. Okay. Launch control. Get him out there. Put him into a skid. Goes into the gravel. And he's out. Hopefully. Don't we bash to the side. He's dead. I don't know if I have the grip to spend a big shot. But what I need, you bringing me up, then we're gonna psych. We're not gonna use bouncing around. I don't think we're using anticipation. Get these going. Weight transfer, perfect. 9 grip. Okay. So I have 8 left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The exact amount, but then it would be, I feel like that would be terrible. Okay, let's do that. Hang on. Maybe I need reload first. Yeah, let's reload first. Get the shield up. And then the card draw. Hulk or Bulk? Oh, that's what it was. I shifted 2 spaces, which gave me the grip rather than 1 space for the shield. I think that if I just go weight transfer here, I mean, the shield is so high. 16, we should be good for whatever they throw at us. Famous last words. Though I could still Hulk if he's gonna like grenade and combo on me. Yeah. What do I do? How do I get the health? I just want the health. There it is. Oh, you do? Yes, you click on that first, and then you go one gear. Gotcha. I gotcha. 24. He's planning. What you got? I need your scrap. Pushes me back, puts me into a skid, pushes me back farther. This is not good. Okay, get out of there. I don't want to flirt with the guardrail. Puts me back even farther. The harpoon is going to smack me. Here he goes with the harpoon. Yep, pulls me in. Then he bashes me. 6 health. Boom. The debris. There it is. Zed the Dude Murdoch. The round ends. After reaching 22 nodes, winning 8 battles, destroying 12 opponents, collecting 174 scrap with a run score of 100. Hey, we unlocked the new driver, Eddie Swift Daddy, after having beaten him. All right, and there's the roguelike elements. You were able to come back, start the next run with new toys. If you guys want to see us try and take revenge on the tournament and enter in a second time, you're going to have to show some love to the video. Let me know in the comments down below if you'd like to see some more of this game. I am really loving it. It is very hard. We'll see if we're able to come back and do any better. Till next time, thank you guys for watching. Have a good one.